So I did my MPW here in 2011. So this is a familiar platform, but then there was a long gap, about 4 years or so. I didn't come back here. Well-being, it's redefining health and wellness. It's a new concept in health industry. My name is Rupa. About ourselves, we registered in 2012. Operation started in 2013. So it's almost 6 years old. It's a brick and mortar model. Why it's a new concept? Because integrative and functional medicine itself is very new in the country. Although it's pretty old in Western system of Western healthcare system.
Sorry for interrupting.
You may want to do a 30-second introduction to that.
When I say new approach in industry, this is a platform where we have brought in the Western system of medicine and the Eastern system of medicine together. The doctors work functionally together. The whole focus is on the lifestyle problems, where we provide complete solution on reversing the problems, which you have not heard of, because conventionally any lifestyle issues, we only manage it. We only heard of managing it. Let's say for example, diabetes or PCOD or EP, we all know that we have to take medicine lifelong, right? So this approach is trending very fast outside the country. Unfortunately, having the Eastern systems sourced in India, we have not looked at it. We've been doing divide and rule for these two systems of medicine. So I'll tell you about myself and I come to the group. So the uniqueness is combining the holistic approach and the evidence and standardization of the Western system. So what happens with today's generation who wants proof for everything? We need a logical explanation for everything. So although there are Ayurveda, naturopathy, science of the system of medicine is 5,000 year old, today we are asking for proof, right? So we just, the whole approach is to convert this into a new model. So that's what is integrative medicine. And the management team today, which is operating, comes from both clinical and non-clinical background, research and clinical practice background. And I come from the healthcare and management background. So the vision is to actually influence the industry to create a parallel healthcare ecosystem, which is patient-centric and complementary and not disease-centric. What we've been seeing simple analogy, that is so many hospitals and nursing homes have mushroomed in the last 10 years. In spite of it, the number of disorders or the number of diseases have not increased. It's only increasing. We are only increasing the lifespan. But the suffering is continuing and it is becoming more younger in age, right? So then what is the problem? So, and to attain the highest standards, see, Ayurveda, naturopathy, being practiced in India is not very new. It's been happening. But how the newer generation is accepting this? Although there is a big shift happening, but people are not very sure about it. So then what do we need to do? We need to create standards. And here in our model, the allopath front ends the whole thing. So what happens? The logical front and the evidence front comes in the forefront. To create culture of integrated practice. Today what's happening is, the culture of doctors or practicing doctors, when you go to an allopath, he badmouths the Eastern system. And when you go to the Eastern system, they will badmouth. It's very difficult for them to work together. So we are creating a platform where they can work together. So therefore, why we are building this system, that's where we are there for the last 6 years, we are building a network of medical professionals, because you don't get them ready. You need to get the medical professionals and transform them. So we also have a training module working parallelly. So what is this integrative approach? This is going to be the next generation medical practice. And this is the future where people have empowered this even outside the country, where the government was supposed to take up a lot of initiatives to, because what is happening is the lobbying of the pharmaceutical companies and the medical industry has not really allowed something like this to happen for a very long time. Although in 1990 it started, this whole revolution started outside. Only in the last 15 years this has developed largely outside the country. So what is the big advantage of it? Integrative and functional medicine. Basically integration is integrating the different system. Functional medicine is focus on the root cause, not on the symptoms. Today what we see in allopath is only we focus on the philosophy of the science itself is to focus on the symptom.
Give an example, I think people will connect with you.
Okay.
One example.
For example, if you look at diabetes, we only see our sugar levels, FBS and PPBS, and then go to the doctor. 5 minutes, a prescription is given to increase the potency of the medicine or give a combination. That's it. But the root cause of that is not dealt at all. So any lifestyle issues, the allopath science do not believe in going to the root cause. We generally say that it is unknown etiology or genetics, or it's because of your parentage and things like that. We don't bother too much on the root cause. But if you see the Eastern system of medicine, they only bother about the root cause. Therefore, it takes a little time. So what we've done is by bringing both together, you address the symptom, because today's lifestyle we require faster relief. Let's say you have a pain. I don't want to really suffer with it. So I need an immediate symptom. So your allopath comes into forefront. But at the same time, how long do I take? Do I need to take diabetic medicine for 25 years, 30 years, and end up in the hospital in my last days? But that's what is considered very normal. So this is where the Eastern system comes together. So when we combine both the systems, you are able to give the best to a common man. So the outcome of this would be, you're not only reducing the risk, you're helping people to come out of medication, and also enable the self-panic. A lot of people are getting into self-management. You go to doctor and try and say something, he's not going to understand or he's not going to approve. You parallelly try and do something at home, right? But that's not always guided. Especially when you already have lifestyle problem, these self-medication, depending on the Google and other things, are not recommended. That's where even a very guided self-management is a part of the program. So what do we do? So our services, it's a 6,000 square feet area. Of course, I was disapproved when I came for NPWE. My first pitch was an 80 crore pitch and they said, get started with something small. This is not what you have to get started. So it took almost 3 years for me to really think, how do I bring this entire thing what I had in mind to a smaller setup? So this still I could only close it with a 6,000 square feet area space in North Bangalore, which has got a lot of these services. It has a multi-speciality clinic, lab and diagnostic, integrated program started as an R&D. So it has been a very costly R&D for us. But to sustain myself, we had the multi-speciality and the lab and diagnostic running like a conventional system. Automated therapies, they all initially worked as these doctors were working independently under one screen. It took some time for me to marry them. You know, so now they work functionally together and we've created various programs. So in terms of services in isolation, these are the services what you have on the right hand side available, and these are the experts who are there. But what we have done is we have combined like a formula for each disorder. And what we have done so far in the last 6 years is 300 plus successful diabetic reversal. Now that has been our flagship program. We started with one disorder, and I mean the conviction had to be built even in the doctors to see this kind of result. Although this has diabetic reversal as a program is happening in pockets only by Ayurveda guys or in some of the places only, but a lot of complicated case or a lot of challenging case or a lot of uncontrolled case were not being handled. So what we did was, when you have the advantage of both, it was possible for us to see every case. And so for us, that was, there was a first case who was a 68-year-old man, 14 years diabetes, 4 years he was on insulin. We brought him out of insulin in 4 months time. Now that was the first case. After that we increased to 11 to 13 and we have now 13 plus. Now we have created programs for 20 plus disorders. BP and thyroid reversal, arthritis, back pain, anything where you generally have to take medicine lifelong. So that is, and then In between, obviously, sustainability was a big question because this was not fetching us immediate money. So this was, there's an R&D work going on. You had to work with a lot of doctors, a lot of mindsets. So we also did enter corporate wellness programs. So corporate, we tied up with insurance, obviously, because of the lab and diagnostic being part of it. We could get a lot of insurance walk-ins, and we also worked with few corporates and also schools. So we tried out, how do you begin this? You know, it all has to start from, you know, people with preventive mind. Only then you can get into the newer segment, which is the managing segment, because you're not focusing on the acute patients who are ready to get admitted in the hospital. So this managing segment are not nowhere, you know, they are ignored. 20-25 years of people who are suffering with these things, they are not directly connected to the hospitals, or probably they are scattered. So you're actually, your segment is this scattered segment. This has been our result. Till this, this happened in the, about in the third year of the startup. If you look at, these are the FPS and PPPS before and after. If you look at, I mean, just to give you an analogy, there's something called HbA1c, if anybody is diabetic, they would know. It's a 3 months average, because FPS, PPS, the sugar level, when we take, on a daily basis is very directly dependent on what you eat the previous day. HbA1c is a standard on which gives you an average of 3 months. And if you look at the HbA1c, which is 14.1, it was reduced to 5.3 in about 3 months and 4 months time. Now this is the kind of result we are able to achieve with by bringing both the systems together. Basically, and we have about 300 plus cases. And very similar to something similar to this. So this we felt is going to be a breakthrough, but it requires a lot of support, because if I tell this, there could be a lot of people who would say, I mean, what's the guarantee, right? So for the guarantee, I can't have some publication which is just released in some Ayurveda journal or something. If we have to do this, we have to release this in good journals, which requires a lot of screening, a lot of evidence creation. The moment we do screening and evidence creation, a common man is not ready to pay that money for screening. You know, he just wants FPS, PPS. Every doctor just probably tells him to get an FPS, PPS, and the medication is titrated. But today, the kind of practices what are happening, anybody can write insulin, and third or fourth year of diabetic people are taking insulin, which is not a great idea, because actually, the aging is decreasing. But then there is no very strong regulation, and therefore, every step what we take is a big challenge for us to do. But if you look at the potential of this market, there's no way, I mean, probably we were a very early entry, that therefore is the struggle, but we are at the right time, I feel, because compared to the healthcare industry and the wellness industry is way ahead in terms of its growth or in terms of the way it's expanding. People are becoming more and more aware. So what we are actually doing is, we're taking a chunk of the health industry, which probably is growing at about 12-17%, and the wellness market, which is growing at 30 plus, and we don't have great statistics to even prove in India. Most of these statistics are the US and UK market, but we are aiming to get penetrated by making use of both the segment. If you look at the growth and market drivers, lifestyle and disease, it is becoming a body. As you grow in the ladder, lifestyle, disease is becoming a partner. In your 30s today, it's becoming, in fact, in my own experience, when we started with some of the corporate programs, 35-40% of the people, when we would do mass screening, would have lifestyle issues. Today, the trend is, last year, we did a mass screening to Xiaomi, where the employee's average age was between 28 and 38, not even crossing 40-45, except the senior management.
Okay, we should do more minutes.
Oh, okay. It was almost 65% of employees had lifestyle issues. So, the major drivers for it is lifestyle disease becoming a burden to a family, not only an individual, failing medical system, in spite of so many hospitals, there is no solution for this. And our economic indicators say that every person is becoming more and more aware of this, and they want to try more. So it's the segment for us to focus is between 30 and 55. And if you look at the evolution of integrative medicine, I will not go to the details, but it started evolving in 1990s, but actually it started taking shape in 2000. 2012 to 2019, every university outside the country.
No, but East has been far ahead in the integrative medicine. It was in the China and Southeast Asia, right?
Now they are influencing the West. Today when
no, but they are far more established. I think here you are one.
Yeah.
But
right.
There are actually many like this.
Right. Yeah. Every other, except India,
right.
I think every other country is talking about integrative medicine.
No, not talking.
They are practicing, yes.
So what is working there? See, at least India is pretty similar in Southeast Asia. Why is it that it's not going?
See, China has, in my understanding, what I have studied is everywhere, wherever integrative medicine is being practiced, China is in the forefront. They're talking about Chinese herbs.
So China is pretty ahead, but see, you can see that China administration is such, they are able to push it.
Right.
But Southeast Asia, that's actually pretty ahead.
So slowly now Ayurveda is entering. Today, in fact, compared in the last 6 years, last one and a half.
I'm just trying to understand why is it so slow compared to them.
I see the regulation being one of the strong thing, and the resistance from the allopath is not allowing. Because if you look at all the wellness,
if you look at Southeast Asia, all of us had the same European rulers.
Right?
So why they are able to bounce back so much, so fast into it? Why are we resisting it?
It is similar to yoga.
So our milestone in the strategy has been from 13 to 19, we launched, ran it more like a multi-speciality clinic, not really ready to talk about it in a big way. We were only doing it on one-on-one basis when people would come in, so because we had to work on the proof of concept. So now we're ready with the proof of concept. Then the conceptualization of integrative and functional medicine with more of patient advocacy is something we introduced. And now we have the programs. Now this requires a lot of technology backup, you know, for duplication too many services. So for us right now, we're looking at establishing the new age clinics first in the corporate. Because we've already tasted success in corporates, and this is nearest to the audience who can understand this. So right now we have a clinic, we're looking at establishing another clinic in South Bangalore, we're now in North Bangalore.
North Bangalore,
then? In Sakarnagar. So now looking at
a similar size, slightly larger
than what we have, because we also felt the location what we chose in the first, as the first center was not the right location, so it took more time for us to...
6,000 square feet.
Yeah, that's a 6,000 square feet. And what we're looking at...
You're paying a bomb on rent.
Yeah, yes. And now looking at, you know, while establishing in the South, we're looking at moving to a little smaller space in South North Bank, because the real estate is really, increased in the last 2 years. So what we looked at is a more viable model would be at the corporate, which is a lease model. So New Age Clinic, and this whole center, I mean, this whole viability would also come in with, there is a benefit of volume when you have more centers, because the intellects, it's intellect driven model,
so
although it is physical. It's about 5 New Age clinics at tech parks is what we're looking at.
Inside
the tech park.
So infrastructure is taken
care. Yeah, infrastructure.
But you still need to pay an investment.
Yeah, right. So we're looking at something like this. One is a New Age integrated clinic where 50% of the revenue would be with a subscription model. That means we are on site and on clinic, both kind of services. Because we have tried doing this, I mean, we experimented in Manyata, where we would not restrict only to the clinical services here. We would also focus on the non-clinical services like the fitness and nutrition and the mind sprint and things like that, where you reach out to people, because a lot of people do not open up when they have the lifestyle issues. So connect with them on the preventive aspect or to become proactive and then get connected with the integrative model. So we're looking at actually and at the center, we focus more on disease specific problems. So diabetic reversal, thyroid reversal. So people come back here. And this is what has been our, in the first 3 years, we on an average, we were able to reach to about 135 to 145. I mean, obviously it started at 58 crore and we touched 1.32 and we touched almost 2 crore, 68 lakh coming only from the corporate business. But then I had to make a choice whether I'm doing a corporate business or integrative. So we had to really put in more effort on integrative approach. So I had to cut down on this vertical. Of course, it fell down, it affected. But if you look at the unit price of individual services, it was about only 500 or 600. But with integrative approach, where you do a subscription model of 1 month to 3 months, it's going to increase. This is bare minimum what we've started with. 15,000 is an average, because there are programs which cost only about 5,000 to 7,000. There are programs which cost about 30,000 to 35,000 based on the number of days. So this is what we intend to look at. So I would say at this stage, it's only a proof of concept. We have a great cases to submit or showcase. Now we need to actually, because I'm
this
not
is from how many corporates?
Where do you see the corporate?
No,
this 15,000 subscription. No. This is with an integrated programs. This is the average cost of the program I've taken. If you look at the first 3 years, the average unit price was only about 350-500. So that was the volume which was giving me about 8 to 11 lakh per month. Slowly, from the last 3 to 4 years to currently, the integrated programs, now that we're ready with the integrated programs, every program we do, let's say I do a diabetic reversal program on an individual,
the
an average cost comes
to 30-day, 20-day, 2-week,
right,
whatever.
Right.
It's not a per visit. So that's
where she's. Right. So this is no more going to be, so it has an advantage of both, a daily, a subscription model and a one-time model. If you've seen any clinic or hospital, it's a one-time model, right? You just go once and get rid of something. Whereas here, it's going to be subscription model. That's why, because there is a wellness component. You're actually selling habit-changing process to people.
What are you looking for? You're looking for technologies.
Yeah, we need to strengthen these things. Of course, the resource matters, and for the quality control, there's a technology bit which needs to come in. So what we've actually done is, while we do direct-to-consumer digital marketing and other things to increase the awareness about this concept itself, we also feel corporate parallelly has to get, because that's where the brand building exercise and also the footfalls comes in. So while these two focus happens with the private limited company, which is Aurasia Wellness, that's a well-being brand, we felt we have to create a foundation. We just created that because we can get an access to the grants and the CSR funding happening, because the research part and other things, probably instead of spending money on the investors' money, that would fetch us a lot, because research is a must for this, for us to get the product in the right form. This is being the team. See, generally what happens, technology front ends it and the infrastructure comes later in lot of established business. Whereas here, because the concept is new, we felt the brick and mortar first and then getting to technology front ending is a way to go ahead, because you need to have the product and you need to have the intellects coming together and putting certain documentation very strongly. Without that, technology cannot happen. So, yeah, except Mahendra. So one of this co-founder story, I really first attempt was for to find a co-founder. I did not find, finally made my husband and my father as co-founders. So he's not a full-timer, but then yes, he handles the operations. This is my father. All others are full-timers. Dr. Rama Mishra has been associated with us for the last 5 years. Through him, we got started, but he's not a full-time, he's a professor in YDE Hospital, but I could find one doctor who had this conviction in integrative medicine, who believed that this is the future, because he also had an exposure in research. So he's a diabetologist. Now, a lot of things works around him. He is somebody who joined us recently, more as an employee, right now not a director. But he comes from, he was with the UK, exposure to integrative medicine, how integrative medicine works outside. He comes with that experience. Dr. Kaveri got frustrated with the government, came out after 15 years in Ayush. So she was also looking at something different to be done, and that's why she's associated with me for the last 5 years. Dr. Daya is somebody who again wanted to associate with the integrative medicine. He became an entrepreneur too, came out of corporate hospital. He is an NRI, but then obviously his association is not full-time, but what he is doing is he's helping us to affiliate with some of the international organization which is practicing integrative medicine for us to set certain standards, like Arizona Center, Duke University, Cleveland. He comes from that because he is connected with a lot of integrative. So we are now planning with him to do a lot of exchange programs. This is what we're looking at. In fact, I could divide this entire 2.35 crore into three clusters. One is to stabilize our current system, current center, and establishing the new center. The second center, which is in South Bangalore, we have the space, but we need to establish the place. The second is for the tech park setups. So obviously infrastructure and setup, resources, technology development, a lot of, because today we have the product, that we know the technology know-hows and how it has to be taken. So this requires quite a bit of money. And then reach out programs, we've absolutely not done much except some local branding and local activities. So we need to do more of digital and reach out programs. So this is where we would like to look at. And only when we work at together, you know, benefit of volume, when I say simultaneously, when we work at this, returns are good. Profitability is pretty high when we work at the volume. With one center, second center with an OPD setup, without an inpatient setup, it becomes very difficult for us to reach the profitability. This is, thanks.